Hi everyone, my name is Diego. I'm a student from Unica University. I belong to the program Bilingual Education, and today we're going to be talking about the social discipline model. I'm going to be explaining with my partner Kevin Perea, and I hope you enjoyed and learned a lot with this video. Have fun!
Social discipline model refers how human beings relate each other. Human beings are sociable by nature. We have the need to belong and be accepted by others as well. The personal interpretation determines how a person is going to behave in a particular situation. The problem is
that Drakers believe that people are primarily motivated by their need to belong. That means that our behavior is directed towards finding an important place in the social world. Another key point in Draker's theory is about the discipline. He mentioned that discipline is not punishment. Discipline is based on mutual respect, teaching students that there are natural consequences to select actions.
So guys, there are four categories in a student's misbehavior. The first one is when a student is seeking for attention. The second one is when a student is showing control or power. The third one is when a student is seeking for revenge. And the fourth one is when a student displays inadequacy. So now we're going to talk about each one of these.
Attention seekers. In this case, a student just wants to get the attention of the teachers. They want to be noticed. So those students must be disciplined if they don't respect, if they are talking a lot during their classes, or they are making jokes. As well, if you as teacher feel annoyed because of these behaviors, that means the goal of those students is attention getting. Power and control. When attention getting fails, students move on to another and more problematic behavior such as power. So in this case, a student want to be in charge of everything, so they want to have the control as well.
So guys, now we're going to talk about their revenge misbehavior and how can we recognize these students. When a student wants to hurt the teacher of other students, and not only physically but also emotionally, it can be described as a student who is seeking for revenge. But what is the reality? The reality is that these students are looking for love and also for affection. Okay, now it's our turn to talk about the displays inadequacy misbehavior. But which are the characteristics of these students? Different from the previous categories, they don't seek for attention. These students feel worthless and incapable to do anything. They don't pay attention to the classes and they constantly manifest not being prepared for any task. Another important key point in Draker's theory talks about praise or encourage. Draker explains that encouragement is more important than any other aspect in child raising. Encouragement focuses on effort rather than achievement, providing a positive feedback. On the other hand, praise is very different from encouragement. Praise stimulate competition and selfishness.
Now, we are going to talk about how the teachers must react when a student misbehaves according to the four categories we have mentioned previously. As teachers, some corrective measures of this behavior will be the first one, to ignore the attention-seeking behavior. The second one, no verbally make the child feel love. Of teachers, some corrective measure of this behavior will be the first one, use friendly eye contact. The second one, be fair and cold in your wording. The last one, give choices, not orders. Of teachers, some corrective measure of this behavior will be A. Emphasize. B. Reestablish the relationship. C. Remove the audience. D. Use logical consequences that are not punishing. As a teacher, some corrective measure would be 8. Don't cause or show pity to a student. V. Avoid doing the assigned work for the child. Promote independence and small success. C. Redirect their self-talk.
Okay guys, thanks for watching our video. I hope you have learned and enjoyed a lot with this. Don't forget to subscribe and give us your thumb up. Bye! Por ti te decides por mí, a la misma hora dan ganas de ti, te dan ganas de mí, a la misma hora quiero sentir aquí.
Your reaction, how you are going to react to a particular situation with your students. Okay? Uy, qué lindo, parce.
A la misma hora, 3:04 de la mañana.
So today we're going to be talking about that.
Ven, mata estas ganas, vamos a llegar a mi cama. Que todo el ignorado por ti, todo ha sido por ti. Mi cuerpo sin saber ti, mi cuerpo sin saber te llama. Y estas no son horas de llamar, pero es que el deseo siempre puede más. Podemos